Welcome back, everyone. I am the Depressed Eeyore, and this is Dark Souls 2. Well, I have some bad news. I did a little bit of grinding, and I didn't get a Dark Steel Katana. Good news is, I found 4 Dark Steel Katanas. So, let's take a quick look at it. Right now I have a plus 6 one when I was upgrading it. You might notice I have a whole lot of minuses and not very many pluses. That's because the requirements for this thing is 25 dexterity. I've already leveled up a little bit with what souls I had and what I gathered. So I just now came back with enough souls to get the last 2 dexterity points I need to meet the requirements. So show the item info. Black steel katana wielded by a lone knight, one of the sturdiest types of katana preferred by masters of the quick draw. In the heyday of his land, the old iron king fancied entertaining dubious and dubious guests from faraway lands. Most of them were charlatans, but amongst the riffraff were true masters of authentic and refined arts. So let's go ahead and get that up and running. Actually, there's a few things we've got to do. One, we've got to burn this sublime bone dust. Also, those of you keeping track of my death count, add one. I got invaded while I was in Iron Keep, and the guy just absolutely rocked me. I'm not really angry about it. He was an archer, and he shot me with one arrow and it took half my life away. And I literally, he was literally sniping me with that bow. I couldn't target him because I was too far away. And I was too busy trying to heal myself, so he just shot me twice and that was game over. It was pretty short, that was a very short match. So yeah, add one to my death counter.
If you're keeping track.
The other thing we forgot was, the other thing we forgot was to upgrade our Estus flask. Okay, none of those. Level up. Ooh. Alright. So, 25 dexterity. Dexterity increases your, dexterity attack rating and gives you poison. It increases your poison and bleed damage, and it will increase your physical defense. Okay. So let's take a look at this again. Right now, this sword, my Heat Knight sword plus 7 does. What is that? That's 205. Does about 342 damage. And this does about 261 damage. Not too bad. I mean, if you wield it two handed, it'll do more damage as well. But this is what I'm going to stick with. I'm going to go ahead and start working on the Black Steel Katana and learning how to use it. Even if it's weaker, because katanas are cool. So yeah, here's our Black Steel Katana. So standard slash is there. Wow, that's pretty cool. Let's see that again. Alright, and then let's go two-handed with it. Oh wow, this time it actually... Okay. So yeah, we'll be sticking with this for a bit. Until we get a better katana anyway. Right now we can't upgrade it until we get chunks. The easiest way to get chunks is by going through that bell tower. That bell tower is probably going to destroy us, just saying. let's see. I'm going to take a look at a few things here. I might consider respecking, just so I can maybe lower my attunement a little bit, and then using that to put points into dexterity. But for right now, I guess we'll stick with what we have. I could get another attunement slot for spells at 40, though we don't really need one right now, so I think I'll be devoting everything I can to dexterity. Alright, let's go ahead and do this bad idea. Oh, I would like to point out that despite being part of the blue and not having the ring on, I didn't get any help when I got invaded. So either there's no blue sentinels around, or certain other requirements for limiting them, or the patch that made it so you don't have to have the ring doesn't work properly. I don't know. But that's the general gist of it. Anyway, where am I going? Here we are. Alright, we're gonna go back into the tower. Against all better judgment, I have no experience with the katana. It does seem to have longer reach. That's about all I know about it. It looks freaking awesome. It looks a lot better than the sword. I mean, the sword's awesome. It does a lot, really good damage, but... katana, man. But yeah, like, literally the first kill I got, I dropped like a black seal katana, so... Alright, if you need to, summon people... Oh, wow. It already went mist on me. Might as well talk to you.
Update! The bell belongs to the princess, it do. Stay back and we slice you to bits. In my chunks, we shan't be left. Stay back all your pieces.
He's coming. Sorry about that. I got invaded while having a conversation. Oh, there's two of them. Great. And he's waiting for the other guy. So I'm gonna be attacked from behind. Yep, he's gonna attack me from behind. Getting backstab. So yeah, a lot of people don't like this place. It definitely is frustrating, but it's joining the Belfry Covenant was probably the best thing I've ever done. It got me really experienced with PvP. I'm still suck at it. Hey, they closed the door. That's good. That's what I do when I PvP'd as the serving the bell tower. I'd always close the door if I was close enough to do so. But yeah, I got caught. I managed to catch him, and I almost finished him off. But then I caught the, yeah. So the slashes are very different. I don't even remember what the sword's called. The sword I had originally, all my slashes were like on the right side, and now I kind of do a slash from the right and from the left. So it does have its limitations. Anyway, I'll try to keep talking to him. I mean, it's not like I don't have any souls left. But this guy's gonna...
Long time ago, the princess should know me. Yes, just like so. To guard this bell for the prince's honor. Stay away, foul undead, or you'll be a goner. Stay back! It belongs to the princess, it do! You wish to guard the bell, you do! For the prince and the princess forever!
For true.
Yes. Now it's funny.
Here for you.
We get a ring. Thank you.
When you round the bell, you'll be brought near.
Alright.
When the bell is in trouble,
the ring brings you here.
Yep. Slice them to shreds, whoever they are, whoever be, they near but they far.
Slice them to pieces for the princess.
Okay. So yeah, we can talk to him some more if we want to, but we're now part of the Belfry Covenant, or the Bell Keepers. What's funny is you can actually kind of choose which side you are of the bell. You can defend either this bell or the one that's in the Iron Keep. man, that thing has some actual ability to... It has reach, and it causes some flinching pretty well. Oop, let's go get that item. I'm gonna get invaded. Yeah, there it is. I wanna fight here, all places. Got me. Now, something about these spirits, they're gray spirits, they're known as gray phantoms. You're nowhere near me. How are you hitting me? That's the issue. The biggest issue I have with PvP. Those little rapiers were hitting me even though they weren't reaching me. And it's always in their favor whenever I'm PvPing. Anyway, so these are known as gray phantoms. They're not red phantoms. They don't sin. This is completely legit. In this case, as a gray phantom, they cannot use. They are not allowed to use Estus Flask. They can't. They can still cast the heal spell if they happen to know it, but they can't use Estus Flask. That's their biggest disadvantage. But their advantage is they can come in twos. Needless to say, I'm probably gonna end up losing my my souls out of this. We'll go ahead and just rush our way in. Also, I'm still getting used to this katana, but it's pretty good. I can get four swings with it, even though it's a heavier weapon. I'm gonna go ahead and just open with Emit Force. Good work. Now, if you are part of this tower and you invade, go after the other one, like you invade it, every one of these black phantoms you kill counts as a kill. The way you rank up with this is through kills. There you go. Gotcha. These little dwarfs, they're pretty rough. Fog gate that's blocked right now, we need to open that gate. To open the gate, we have to get this lever up here. And to get this lever up here, we gotta deal with this nonsense. Drink. Get the chest. So I don't have to loot it later on. Radiant Life Gem and a Twilight Herb. Pull this. Success. So that's all you have to do? Hello, everybody. Alright, let's get out of here. So now I don't have to climb up to this top floor anymore. All I have to do is go through the fog gate. If I go through the fog gate, it's successful. Any phantoms that were after me will immediately disappear. So there we go. We are safe. Now, as mentioned, we have a new ring. Where is it? Guardian seal. Oh, here it is. Bellkeeper seal. Ringing for the Bellkeeper Covenant. I don't believe it gives you any stats. Nope. So, join this covenant and wear this ring to be automatically summoned to the world of an invader of the Bellkeeper's domain. The twin bells symbolize the bond between two lovers who can never be reunited. The Bellkeepers are their internal guardians, for that is their love. That is their cause. So, one is for the prince, the one is for the princess. I believe the one we have right now is for the prince? I don't know. In any case, let's go ahead and gear up. We don't need this ring. And all we have to do is just wear it. So you notice that my little symbol is now pulsing, as you see in the top left. As long as you're essentially around the Lost Bastille area, you can be summoned. Even if you wear this ring, though, you cannot go into your own tower. You'll be attacked. I'm pretty sure that's just to avoid people from just joining the Covenant to get through the tower without being attacked, which is completely fair in my opinion. As far as being the two-on-one stuff, I don't have any issue with it, especially since the person that invades the tower can actually summon people, summon White Phantoms on his side, and he can summon up to two, so he can have three. Disconnected for multiplayer session. Okay, that didn't work. I'm still connected, because I can still see the bloodstains. Messages. So, I don't really have too much issue with it. Also, it's just kind of, it's an optional area. You do not have to go through the tower. It leads to an optional boss and a key, I believe. The other thing to note is be careful of some players that are part of the Covenant and join you if you're defending the bell. Some of them have this weird sense of, I guess, quote-unquote honor that they will not attack, they won't gang up on a player, which is completely stupid because if they have issues with that, they shouldn't join the Covenant. But just take it in this role-playing aspect. You're there to guard the tower. That's your job. So, that's what both your jobs are. So guard the freaking tower. If anyone invades it, kill them. Doesn't matter how you do it, do so. Take advantage of the fact you have home field advantage. Take advantage of the fact that the Black Phantom gnomes will fight for you. I mean, your job is just to protect the bell tower. So yeah, it really annoys me when someone just stands there and watches you struggle to fight a player. Because it doesn't help anyone. It doesn't help. You might think you're helping them learn, but you're really just being more of a distraction in any case. So if you really don't want to like help out, then don't put on the ring. It's that simple. I mean, as far as like doing solo stuff, there are plenty of there are two covenants already that allow you to do dueling. One of them is the Rat King, the other one's the Dragon Covenant. By the way, I know where the Dragon Covenant is, so don't stop spamming me. I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get bazillion spams by the time you guys see this video, but that's okay. The way you get join the Covenant is actually through that merchant, and so forth. Anyway, I'm trying to get. Let's unequip the ring and re-equip the ring and see if that resets things. In the meantime, I'm gonna go ahead and practice more with this katana. If I don't get anything in I guess a minute or two, I'll just move on. I mean, look at that, you hold the sword so cool. You do like a running attack right through the doorway. I mean, man, that's so awesome. Anyway, actually, let's go talk to what's his face. Might as well see if he has anything to say about the soul we just got. As far as the rewards for the Covenant, every time you defeat somebody and protect the bell tower successfully, you will get a Titanite Chunk, making it one of the best ways to get Titanite Chunks ever. You also get the standard fare of souls for the kill, so make use of that as well. The other thing is once you hit, I think it's like, I don't even remember how many kills you need. You need a lot of kills, I recall. You need like 100 kills to get rank 3. Rank 3 gets you the armor. I don't remember what ranks 1 and 2 do. They weren't that important. Right, trespassers set foot in the bell tower. Invading world is a great spirit. So I can't heal myself, but I can use the heal spell if I need to. Which, if they let me use the heal spell, that's their own damn fault. Alright, so this gate's open, so they're probably trying to get through the fog gate. Drop down. Oh, he's fighting a gray spirit down there. There we go. Easy peasy. Wait, gotta drop down. Aw, he blew up in the door! What a jerk! Titanite Chunk. So yeah, take advantage of the tower. I mean, you can shoot down from above and stuff like that. It's pretty awesome. Oh, hello. Ow. Is that petrification? Yeah, it is. Alright, I gotta get used to this sword. I'm used to being able to swing across my right side. Alright, keep the ring on for now, just until I get to the guy, and then we'll go from there. The only disadvantage for katanas is they're actually not very durable. This one's one of the more durable ones, but that's still like only 40 durability compared to other weapons. Aha, two shot. Just don't have much HP. Yep. Oh, thank God I didn't hit him. That would have been annoying. Hey, what's up?
Well, this is a most twisted soul. Very good. Prepare to pierce.
Okay, you say the same, Jack. We did unlock new stuff. Nothing I care about, though. Nothing I care about.
Drang Lake is dead. Feeble cursed one.
Okay, let's go ahead and move on. Yes, yes, I know. Let's go ahead and travel. Where are we going next? Shaded Wood. Sounds like a place we can go to. So, we gotta go through Death Woods. We're kind of running low on time, so at least we get a brief introduction of the Death Woods. And then I'll probably off screen. Oh, I can upgrade my sword. Go do that real quick. Since I got a Titanite Chunk. What I'll do off screen, though, is I'll grind up some Titanite Chunks. I don't really need many, I only need 5. The sword up to where it needs to be, and then I have a Titanite slab, so I can get this katana up to +10. I could do the same for the sword, but we're sticking with this. This is what we're gonna be doing. Damage is gradually catching up. 205? No, it's not catching up, but whatever. Alright.
I'll be around if you make it back.
Yes, yes. I don't have enough to level up, I don't believe. Nope, I need 19,000 to level up. Okay. Anything I need to attune? No. Okay. But yeah, I'll be focusing on dexterity, so if I get any level ups, I'll be all into dexterity. I mean, the only time I'll need more attunement slots is if we get more spells, but I could just replace some of the spells I have already. Just go with that. Alright, so that's all been taken care of. Alright. I don't know how it's gonna look on YouTube. Oh. Oh wow, I can invade stuff while here? Okay. Well, why not? We'll see some PvP. Oh my god, it puts us in here? Oh great. So we get to protect both towers. That's kinda weird. Alright, someone's... Oh, well, that was easy. Well, this is gonna get us free stuff, I guess, and... Oh, there he is. Thanks. Thank you for the Titanite Chunk. It is possible to dual wield Darksteel katanas, but I don't really have any intention of doing so. I find dual wielding big weapons like this kind of silly. I mean, you'll see players do it, where they do wield like giant super swords. Alright. The thing about this place is all the enemies here are invisible, which means I cannot target them, which means my magic is practically useless. Okay, I can see one over there. I mean, yes, they are invisible, but with like the fog and stuff, they kind of have a weird outline to them. It almost looks like they're phantoms, like little those little ghosts you see of other players. Which makes this place even freakier, because you can see freaking ghosts of other players. Okay. I don't know if you saw him. These guys patrol. There's one patrolling over there. He's behind the tree right now. Now he went behind the bigger tree. Now he's coming in. Yep, he's moving in. He spotted me. Nope, went around. Oh my god, this stage just kills the eyes. Come on, I know you're here. Okay, I see him. And he has a crossbow out. All of them usually have crossbows out. Coming at me? Yep, there you are. Gotcha. These guys are not worth any spirits, souls, I believe. Or if they are, they're not worth. I don't think I got any souls from that. So yeah, the only time you'll ever really see them is if you hit them, and then you'll see their health bar. See an item over there? There's a ring you get here that's really good for casters, by the way. But right now I'm taking the left route. The left route is probably the safest. What it's worth. Okay. Okay, pick up item. Soul of a Proud Knight and a human effigy. What's over here? Something. Whatever. Okay. You know, say hi to another person.
Leave me be. I like it quiet. Leave me be. What business have you here, traveler? You may call me Vengal, if I deserve a name in this sorry state. 'Tis rare to flap these gums. This is pleasant. Long ago, I was hired to defend the kingdom. I remember a long, brutal fight, and then somebody killed me. Or so I thought. Game two, and found myself like this. I don't know what explains it, but it's not so bad, really. Now I watch the days go by, and gaze at the night sky, thinking of the finer things, far removed from war. I'd grown weary of battle, but did not realize it until now.
So yeah, this is a guy's head that we're talking to.
I know not what brings you on this journey, nor will I deign to ask. You may bear a great burden, don't we all? I prefer to stay my distance. But I want to warn you of something. My body. I see visions, my body, headless, raging without me. my body, wielding my sword, a sword forged only to kill. My body will show no mercy. If you see the wretched thing, stay far away.
We'll continue the conversation after this fight. I also finished up the conversation before I called a video. We're out here again. This time down here. Climb this ladder, get out of here. Good news is it's pretty easy to get back to where you need to go. Oh.
I'm sorry.
That's the freaking wooden thing that I mentioned before. The thing that said, I'm sorry. Well, I now have enough to upgrade my sword again. I don't like fighting there though, because it seems like I join in way too late. But whatever.
I learn new things every day. Things never learned in battle. And thanks to you, I've recalled the joy of conversation. If I can help you, if you require something, do speak up.
Or Jester. Decapitate Jester. You can buy a claymore or a greatsword here, if you didn't have one already. Ring of Soul Protection nullifies death and protection, but breaks. So it's a stronger form of the Ring of Life Protection. I'm gonna go ahead and buy it, just so I can have it. Destructive Great Arrows, got a few of those. Lightning Urns, does lightning damage. Gold Pine Resin, we can get those now, not that it matters. And Magic Barrier, we haven't gotten this spell yet. This is a miracle that gives you resistance to magic, lightning, fire, and dark. This miracle is said to shield its casters from the rock's armor and was common amongst the Wizard Knights of Mira. Or Mira. So we'll go ahead and get that.
Farewell. May we meet again. One day soon.
Alright. I'm gonna go ahead and call this a video. I'm the Depressed Eeyore, and this is Dark Souls 2. When we come back, I'll actually go ahead and keep this ring on, so we can go through this fog place while also getting some PvP in. Or at least, you know, watch someone die, I guess, because we haven't been getting much luck there. But I guess that's the plan. So I'm the Depressed Eeyore, Dark Souls 2. This is Denshi. See you guys later.